Hello students, today we'll solve some simple questions related to the trigonometry which will give a grip to you on solving the questions, attempting the questions which are difficult, right? So please see as I do, right? As I write the questions, you must also try with a pen and paper in your hand, right? If you don't get, obviously the solution is here, but you must retry these sums, redo them, try again and again so that your concept of trigonometry becomes strong. Let's start. So this is the question, right? Triangle is given to you, theta 1, theta 2, sum of the sides are given, some are not given. So better before you start solving, you identify the unknown sides, right? And find out the values of those sides. So if you see here in the triangle ABC, right? In triangle ABC, so if you redraw this triangle, so if this is 5, this is 13, right? Theta 1. Better if the figure is complex or you see more triangles, better redraw them again. This will help you to simplify the questions. So theta 1, right? This is 13, 5. You have to find out the perpendicular. So how will you get perpendicular? Pythagoras theorem, right? As per the Pythagoras theorem, perpendicular will be square root of hypotenuse square minus base square. So hypotenuse square will be 169 minus 25, so that is square root of 144, ultimately it gives 12. So I got the value of perpendicular as 12. Now I have been also given another triangle ACD. Here also I don't have this side AD. So in triangle ACD, in this triangle ACD, right? So AC and D, this is theta 2. So AC I got 12, right? I solved here. AC I got it as 12. CD is given as 16. Now find out the hypotenuse, right? This part is hypotenuse, opposite to the 90 degree, opposite to the 90 degree is hypotenuse. So here the hypotenuse will be, formula will be perpendicular square plus base square. So 12 square is 144, 16 square is 256. So 144 plus 256, how much it will be? 400, and square root of 400 is 20. So we found out the value of AD. After finding the missing sides, right, you should do this all stepwise. What did we do in the step 1? Find missing sides. Now after finding the missing sides, we'll start solving the question. So step 2, solve question. Now sine theta 1, what will be the sine theta 1? Now refer to the triangle which has theta 1. So this is the triangle which has theta 1, right? This part, it has theta 1. So sine of theta 1, so we know the formula for sine is perpendicular upon hypotenuse, right? So what will be the perpendicular here? Exactly opposite to the theta 1, right? The the side which is exactly opposite to the theta 1 is perpendicular. So perpendicular is 5 here, and the side which is opposite to 90 degrees hypotenuse. You must know that. Once again, the side which is opposite to the angle, to the given angle, it is perpendicular, and the side which is opposite to the 90 degrees hypotenuse. This is a rule for sure. So here the perpendicular is 5 and hypotenuse is 13. So this is the answer. Then sine theta 2, again here opposite to the theta we have perpendicular, so perpendicular is 16 here. You should write down the formula always. And hypotenuse, as we calculated, right, it is 20. So 4 4s are 16, 5 4s are 20, that is 4 by 5. Tan B, where is the angle B? Angle B is here, or you can refer here. Since there are two triangles, I have redrawn them separately, right? Drawing them separately will help me to identify the values easily. So what will be the tan B? B is this, right? B is this. So opposite to this angle is perpendicular. Now the value of perpendicular changes. When you take theta 1, perpendicular is this. But now if you take angle B, perpendicular is the AC. Right? So what will be the value of perpendicular? 12. Formula is perpendicular upon base. Value of perpendicular is 12. And base is what? Base is the side which contains 90 degree and the angle. So here our angle is B. So 90 degree and angle BC is the base. So 5. So 12 upon 5 is the answer. Sec D. Formula is hypotenuse upon base. So identify what is the hypotenuse for the D. Hypotenuse is always opposite to 90 degree for sure. So hypotenuse is 20. Hypotenuse will never change. If the angle changes, perpendicular and base will change, but hypotenuse will never change. If you see any question, hypotenuse remains same. Base will be, since D we have asked, base will be CD, that is 16. So this one, if you simplify, so that is 5 by 4, correct? Cot is base upon perpendicular, so cot theta 2. So theta 2, for theta 2, perpendicular is 16 and base is 12. So 12 upon 16. So this will be 3 4s are 12, 4 4s are 16. So 3 by 4 is the answer. So that is how this conceptual question is. What have you learned in this question? In this question, you have learned about identifying perpendicular and base based on angle given, right? Based upon whatever angle is given, so based on that angle we identify our perpendicular and base. To the same question, if I add other parts, right, I can say that, prove that sin square theta 1 plus cos square theta 1 is equals to 1, right? Then another question which I add, prove that cos x square b minus cot square b is equals to 1. You know these are square relations. We have already proved them in the last lecture. Let us do them once again, right? Then prove that sec square d minus tan square d is equals to 1. For square relation, one thing is, you have to be very sure. It is called as square relation only when these angles are same, right? Then find value of sine square theta 1 plus cos square theta 2. Now see, this is not a square relation because angles are different. This is a square relation, angles are same. This is a square relation, angles are same. This is again a square relation because angles are same. But here it is not so. Let us try to solve this question. So, sixth one, right? Cos x square b, cot square b. So, let me first find out the value of cos x b. What will be the value of cos x b? Cos x, formula of the cos x is hypotenuse upon perpendicular. So, what is the value of hypotenuse? Cos x b, I can see it here, right? So for b, hypotenuse 13 and perpendicular is 12. So 13 upon 12. Then another value I want is, so I started with 7th one. So let us see 7th one first, then we'll go to the 6th. Cosec B, then cot B. Cot B, what is the value of cot B? B, right? The formula for the cot is base upon perpendicular, right? So what is the base for the B? For B, base is 5, right? And perpendicular is 12. So 5 upon 12. Now substitute in the formula. So taking left hand side, that is cosec square b minus cot square b, correct? So here the value of the b is 13 by 12, and we have square, so square it. The value of cot b, 5 by 12, square it. So this will be 169 upon 144. 25 upon 144. If we simplify, this will give me 144 upon 144, that is 1, and that is the RHS, hence it is proved. Similarly, 6th one, right? So if we solve this one, again I will find out the values of sin theta 1, right? That is perpendicular upon hypotenuse. I will also find out the value of cos theta 1. Formula for cos theta is base upon hypotenuse. So sin theta 1, I have already found out here sin theta 1, that is 5 by 13. And what will be cos theta 1? Theta 1 is here. So what will be the base? Base is this, 12, right? And hypotenuse is 13. So it will be 12 upon 13. So the most and the most important thing in this type of the question is identifying perpendicular and base based upon the angle given. This you have to conceptually be clear, what is the angle, what is the perpendicular, and which is the base. So after finding the values of sin theta and cos theta 1, we can substitute in the formula. Taking left hand side, sin square theta 1 plus cos square theta 1, correct? So 5 by 13 square, 12 by 13 square. This one, if you simplify, it will be 25 upon 169, 144 upon 169, that is nothing but 169 upon 169, that is 1, and that is equals to RHS, hence again proved, right? Similarly, you can do with the 8th sum. Let us try the 8th one. So 8th sum, again what I want here, I want sec D and tan D. So sec D here I have already calculated, so I'll use that. So I'll find out the value of sec D. Sec D is already there, that is 5 by 4. Correct? And tan D. Tan D, I will find out where is D. D is here. So if D is the angle, what will be the perpendicular? This one. What will be the base? 16, right? So 12 upon 16. This one, if I simplify, 3. Now if I use the formula, right, taking left hand side of the question, substitute the values, algebraic simplification, hence proved, right? Very simple. Let us do the 9th one. Now see, your angles are different. Definitely we will not get value as 1, we will get value something else. So this question I have taken to show you that in square relations angles are same, but if it is not a square relation, right, if angles are not same, it is not a square relation. So let us start. So again here I want the value of sin theta 1 and I want the value of cos theta 2. So what is the value of sin theta 1? I have already calculated there, 5 by 13, I can use directly. Cos theta 2, have I calculated anywhere cos theta 2? No. So I will go to the triangle and find out base and height. So here is the triangle, base is 12, as per the angle base is 12, and as per the angle perpendicular is 16. I want hypotenuse, so 12 and 20, 12 upon 20. So if I simplify, 3 4s are 12, 5 4s are 20. Now use sin square theta 1, cos square theta 2, substituting the values in the question. 5 by 13, 3 by 5 square, right? So that is 25 by 169 plus 9 by 25. So LCM will be 169 into 25. So cross multiplication is needed. 25 into 25 plus 9 into 169 upon 169 into 25. Now let us multiply and simplify. 25 25 is 625. 169 into 9. The rough work must be done on the same page. You must make a column, right? If there is a lots of rough work involved, even the drawing of triangle, this is a rough work. In fact, you don't have to show this in the main solution. Even if you show this in the main solution, it creates an impression on the teacher, right, that you are following a algorithmic approach, or you are following a perfect method to solve the questions. So your answer is 2146 upon 4225. See, right? So I hope you have enjoyed solving these 9 questions. Try them once again. It will give you a grip, right? We'll continue with some more sums in the next class.